Hello, Dave Glass here. Now, I love Larry Semon, and I don't care who knows it. His films are the creme de la creme of slapstick, and they're just great. They're just huge, monumental extravaganzas of mayhem. And I know he repeated himself quite a lot, but, you know, what do we expect from one man's imagination? Anyway, this GOWNSHOP film, it's one of those hard-to-see complete Larry Semons. Not that this now is complete, there's no intertitles, but it's about three quarters of the film. And it's a film that isn't normally available. It's, you know, Black Hawk didn't put it out, it's just not around. So while I was editing the footage together, I began to notice some interesting differences. Now just before I get into that, let me give you some background information. Back in the day, before the days of being able to duplicate the edited negative of a completed film, many American film companies created different versions of their films for the European market. Sometimes they just ran two cameras next to each other on the set, like an A and B version of the same film. So while I was cutting this GOWNSHOP film together, I noticed that now and again, there was the odd scene that was different. Now, it wasn't a different angle like you'd get from two cameras next to each other. It was different takes, just now and again. So I'll leave you for the moment to enjoy the film, and then I'll barge back in to show you a few examples when they're occurring. Sorry if you just want to watch this film and not know about this stuff, but for us film geeks, this is the stuff that floats our boats. Anyway, over to Larry and Ollie and some super slapstick. Okay, here's the first example that I noticed, and I thought, hello, what's going on here? So watch the boxes as he falls off the shelf there. Yeah, so that was the first one I noticed, but there's some more interesting ones to come. I'll be back in a mo. There's one for John Bengston. So here's another example. The European prints on the left, the American ones on the right, then they look pretty similar. But notice the second set of curtains on the left blowing in the breeze. See that? And now, watch the plant pot vase thing on top of the pillar on the right. I just find it interesting that it's the elaborate scenes that seem to have the different takes. No wonder Larry Semon was criticised for going over budget all the time. Anyway, back in a mo.
Bye.
Okay, so this next bit's very interesting. European print on the left, American on the right. Ollie chases Larry. Larry appears on one side of the revolving door in one print and on the other in the other print. And there's some other little subtle differences. Obviously a completely different take, as is the next bit, which is very amusing because it's the mirror gag, which Larry did use in some other films. Well, they obviously thought Europeans wouldn't understand it was a mirror. To make it really obvious with a cracked mirror sticker thing on it. So yeah, it's all very interesting. I don't know why they did this on just a few random scenes only. It's interesting that in Cloudy Assassin's Larry Semon book, let's see, on page 193, she says, starting in the 1910s, several cameras were installed or different takes were employed to create a domestic negative and another one for the foreign market. At this writing, we were not able to determine any differences in takes or camera angles for Semon films. Well, we have now, Claudia, so I'm sure there's more to discover.
Mm-hmm.